Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us. Amen. Come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Come, let us worship and fall down before sake I waited for thee, O Lord. My soul has waited for thy word. My soul has hope on the Lord. Revealing to thee the pre-eternal counsel, Gabriel came and stood before thee, O maiden, and greeting thee, he said, rejoice, earth that has not been sown. Rejoice, burning bush that remains unconsumed. Rejoice, unsearchable depths. Rejoice, bridge that leads to heaven. Rejoice, ladder raised on high that Jacob saw. Rejoice, divine jar of manna. Rejoice, deliverance from the curse. Rejoice, restoration of Adam. The Lord is with thee. From the morning watch until night, from the morning watch, let Israel hope in the Lord. Ye appear to me in the form of a man, said the undefiled May to the chief of the heavenly host. How then do ye speak to me of things that pass man's power? Ye have said that God shall be with me, and shall take up his dwelling in my womb. How shall I become the spacious habitation, and the holy place of him who rides upon the cherubim? Do not deceive me with trickery, for I have not known pleasure. I have not entered into wedlock. How then shall I bear a child? For with the Lord there is mercy, and with him is plenteous redemption, and he will deliver Israel from all his iniquities. Ye appear to me in the form of a man, said the undefiled maid of the chief to the chief of the heavenly host. How then do ye speak to me of things that pass man's power? Ye have said that God shall be with me, and shall take up his dwelling in my home. How shall I become the spacious habitation, and the holy place of him who rides upon the cherubim? Do not deceive me with trickery, for I have not known pleasure. I have not entered into wedlock. How then shall I bear a child? Praise the Lord, all nations. Praise him, all peoples. Then the bodiless contained in the womb of a woman. The six-winged seraphim and many a cherubim cannot gaze upon him. Yet he is well pleased to be made flesh from her at a single word. It is the word of God who is to come. Why then do I hesitate and not say to the maiden, rejoice, O lady, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Rejoice, O pure virgin. Rejoice, O bride without bridegroom. Rejoice, O mother of the life. Blessed is the fruit of thy womb.
Reached to heaven, and there the angels of God were ascending and descending on him. Therefore it shall be shut. As for the prince, because he is the prince, he may sit in it to be put bread before the Lord. He shall enter by the way of the vestibule of the gateway, and go out the same way. Also he brought me by the way of the north gate to the front of the temple. So I looked, and behold, the glory of the Lord filled the house of the Lord, and I fell on my face. On my face. A reading from Proverbs. Wisdom has built her house, she has hewn out her seven pillars, she has slaughtered her meat, she has mixed her wine, she has also furnished her table, she has sent out her maidens, she cries out in the highest places of the city, whoever is simple, let him turn in here. As for him who lacks understanding, she says to him, come, eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed, forsake foolishness, and live, and go in the way of understanding. He who corrects the scoffer gets shame for himself, and he who rebukes a wicked man only harms himself. Do not correct a scoffer, lest he hate you. Give instruction to a wise man, and he will still be wiser. Teach a just man, and he will increase in learning. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. For by me, your days will be multiplied, and years of life will be added to you.
Please be seated. Reading from the lives of the saints, this evening we commemorate the Annunciation of our Most Holy Lady, the Theotokos and Ever Virgin Mary. The Feast of the Annunciation is one of the earliest Christian feasts and was already being celebrated in the 4th century. There's a painting of the Annunciation in the Catacomb of Priscilla in Rome, dating from the 2nd century. Council of Toledo in 656 mentions the feast, and the Council in Trullo in 692 says that the Annunciation was celebrated during Great Lent. The Greek and Slavonic names for the feast may be translated as Good Tidings. This, of course, refers to the incarnation of the Son of God and the salvation he brings. The background of the Annunciation is found in the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 1, verse 26 to 38. The Triparion describes this as the beginning of our salvation and the revelation of the eternal mystery. For on this day, the Son of God became the Son of Man. There are two main components of the Annunciation, the message itself and the response of the Virgin. The message fulfills God's promise to send a Redeemer, as stated in Genesis 3:15, I will put enmity between you and the woman, between her seed and your seed and her seed. He shall crush your head, and you shall lie in wait for his heel. The fathers of the church understand her seed to refer to Christ. The prophets hinted at his coming, which they saw dimly. The Archangel Gabriel now proclaims that the promise is about to be fulfilled. We see this echo in the liturgy of St. Basil as well. When man disobeyed thee, the only true God who had created him, and was deceived by the guile of the serpent, becoming subject to death by his own transgressions, thou, O God, in thy righteous judgment, didst send him forth from paradise into this world, returning him to the earth from which he was taken, yet providing for him the salvation of regeneration in thy Christ himself. The Archangel Gabriel was sent by God to Nazareth in Galilee. There he spoke to the undefiled virgin who was betrothed to Saint Joseph. Hail, thou art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God shall give unto thee the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. In contrast to Eve, who was readily deceived by the serpent, the Virgin did not immediately accept the angel's message. In her humility, she did not think she was deserving of such words, but was actually troubled by them. The fact that she asked for an explanation reveals her sobriety and prudence. She did not disbelieve the words of the angel, but could not understand how they could be fulfilled, for they spoke of something which was beyond nature. Then Mary said unto the angel, "How shall this be, seeing I know not a man?" It's found in Luke 1:34. And the angel answered and said unto her, "The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God nothing shall be impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word." And the angel departed from her. In his sermon number 23 on the day of the Annunciation, St. Philaret of Moscow boldly stated that the word of the creature brought the Creator down into the world. He explains that salvation is not merely an act of God's will, but also involves the Virgin's free will. She could have refused, but she accepted God's will and chose to cooperate without complaint or further questions. The icon of the feast shows the archangel with a staff in his left hand, indicating his role as a messenger. Sometimes one wing is upraised as if to show his swift descent from heaven. His right hand is stretched toward the Holy Virgin as he delivers his message. The Virgin is depicted either standing or sitting, usually holding yarn in her left hand. Sometimes she is shown holding a scroll. Her right hand may be raised to indicate her surprise at the message she is hearing. Her head is bowed, showing her consent and obedience. The descent of the Holy Spirit upon her is depicted by a ray of light issuing from a small place at the top of the icon, which symbolizes heaven. In a famous icon from Sinai, a white dove is shown in the ray of light. There are several famous icons of the Annunciation. One is in the Moscow Kremlin in the Church of the Annunciation. This icon appeared in connection with the rescue of a prisoner by the Mother of God during the reign of Ivan the Terrible. Another is to be found in the Dormition Cathedral in Moscow. He was originally located in Ustinum, and was the icon before which St. Procopius the Fool prayed to save the city from destruction in 1290. One of the most highly revered icons in Greece is the Tinos icon of the Annunciation. The Annunciation falls during Lent, but it is always celebrated with great joy. The liturgy of St. Basil or St. John Chrysostom is served even on the weekday of Lent. It is one of the 2 days of Great Lent on which the fast is relaxed and fish is permitted. Glory to God for all things.
Vouchsafe, O Lord, keep us this evening without sin. Lord have mercy.
Da-da! In the sixth month, the archangel was sent to the pure virgin, and with his greeting rejoicing brought good tidings, that the deliverer would come forth from her. And so accepting his salutation with faith, she conceived thee, the pre-eternal God, who was pleased to become ineffably for the salvation of our souls.
Would you show your word?
All right, please.
Yes.
You know where it is?
The apostasy?
Okay, go ahead.
From day to day, proclaim the salvation of our God.
The Theotokos heard a voice she knew not, when the archangel brought her the good tidings of the Annunciation, and accepting the salutation of faith, she conceived thee the pre-eternal God. Therefore, in great rejoicing, we all of our souls.
O Lord of the harvest, who planted the seed of your word in us and watered it with your grace, look upon us now as we work the soil of our hearts, so that the seed you planted may grow and produce fruit in abundance, both in us and in our parish community. Show us how to build up each other for the work of ministry. Help us to use the talents and abilities you have given each of us for the well-being of your church. Fill us with your Holy Spirit, that our hearts may be aflame with love for you. Enable us to structure our lives and our community, that your love and mercy may more effectively be shown in the world. Inspire us as we gather in community to worship you. In our daily lives, help us to maintain our fellowship for the building up of ourselves and our community. For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we send the glory. To your Father who is without beginning, and your all-holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O God, almighty Lord of heaven and earth, and of all creation visible and invisible, in thy ineffable goodness look down upon us, thy people, gathered here in thy holy name. Be our helper and defender in this day of affliction. Thou knowest our weakness, thou hearest our cry and repentance and contrition of heart. O Lord, who loves mankind, deliver us from the impending threat of this coronavirus. Send thine angel to watch over us and protect us. Grant health and recovery to those suffering from this virus. Guide the hands of physicians and healthcare providers, and preserve those who are healthy. Enable us to continue to serve our suffering brothers and sisters in peace, that together we may glorify thy most honorable and majestic name, of the Father and of the Son, Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Confirm, O God, the holy Orthodox faith and Orthodox Christians unto ages of ages. Most holy Theotokos, save us. More honorable than the cherubim, without
metropolitan of all America and Canada, our Lord, the most reverend Alexander, Archbishop of Dallas and the South, this God protected.